What is the way of all the prophets? And what is the way of the righteous ones? So every day we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, guide us the same way you guide them. And don't guide us the same way the kuffar were guided. And don't guide us the same way the Yahud, the Jewish, and the Christian were guided. And we all say Ameen. Everyone say Ameen. Until now, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again. And we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He starts His Quran in three letters. There's no one on the face of this earth knows the meaning of these three letters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the start, from Adam alayhi salam till the day of judgment, He's challenging mankind. He said, whatever you do, whatever you are capable of, whatever you're doing, don't think you know anything. If three letters you don't know the meaning, then what do you know the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So he taught Alif Lam Mim. Till now, even non-Muslims, they going through the Quran and think they're trying to translate these three letters. But till now, no one. And no one will know except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from the start, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, don't think you are something in this world. You know, came for purpose. He did not come for knowing or doing worldly things. You don't know nothing. But this, indeed this kitab that I have revealed to my Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is truly, will be beneficial for the righteous one. It's a guide for the righteous one, muttaqeen. Who are the righteous one? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people who perform salat and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the unseen, and believe in the day of judgment, and they believe whatever you came with to them, and whatever they came before you from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the other prophets, they believe all in this. Those are the righteous ones. And this is the book. This book is the guide for them. They know the meaning. They will know the meaning of this book. They will follow the book, the Quran. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدَىٰ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. Those people who understand the Qur'an, who take the Qur'an, who reflect meaning of the Qur'an, those are the guided ones from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those are the successful ones. So now my respected brothers, we think, what is the way first? We go with the, when Allah says, صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. What is the way of the prophets? All the prophets, from Adam alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every prophet was sent to tell a message to the tribe. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our prophet, he was sent to give us a responsibility, to tell us a responsibility and to give us a responsibility. The responsibility of da'wah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Calling people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no other way. Prophet came to this dunya, did not do da'wah. His first job was da'wah. There's no verse in the Quran, no part of the Quran says that any prophet came to something else other than revealing or telling the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is none of worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came, said, say la ilaha illallah, and put la ilaha illallah inside your heart. Not only say it, it's the effort of la ilaha illallah is required for this Ummah. The effort of la ilaha illallah is required for this Ummah. Not only saying la ilaha, not only the saying of la ilaha illallah. Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, when they entered Islam, they knew the meaning of la ilaha illallah. Then they knew the reality of this La ilaha illallah. Then they knew that for this they need a lot of effort to bring La ilaha illallah, the true meaning of this word, which you went inside the house. So how much effort we required for the brothers to put the truly and 100% yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inside the house. Allah the Lashan of Muqarrun, Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when they believed, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger, الصحابة رضي الله تعالى عنهم after this they did not have any rest. They gave all their life for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. No rest was given to them. They did not care about this world. They knew the reality of this world and they knew the reality of the hereafter. Whatever Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to tell them, they used to put inside their hearts and live the same way Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم lived. The same way Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم taught them to live, they will live. And now, we have everything in front of us. Because now we say, because it's Sunnah I live. This is our Iwana. Sahaba, because it's Sunnah, because it's the way of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, they used to do. And now the Ahwal of the Ummah, because it's Sunnah, they live. Whatever it's what, they do. Fair and so, brothers. Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم so much effort. They still had the fear from Allah سبحانه وتعالى that Allah سبحانه وتعالى might not accept from us. Even Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه, Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه, the Khulafa رضي الله تعالى عنه, all the Sahaba, the Ashr al-Mubashr رضي الله تعالى عنه, and all the Sahaba, whatever they used to give for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, from time, from wealth, from anything, at the end they used to say, will Allah سبحانه وتعالى my respect brothers, this is the level of Sahaba. They have done so much for this effort, so much for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so much to put the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam up, but still they had the fear, oh Allah is from us. And they used to cry day and night for Allah, the acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, we all know Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, if the iman of the whole ummah, from Umar till the day of judgment, put in one side of Spain, and the iman of Abu Bakr put on the other side, the iman of Abu Bakr will overcome all the other people. This is the quality of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. And at the end of his life, you know, we all know the story of Hanbala. You know, when Hanbala he was running, he said, Nafaka Hanbala, Nafaka Hanbala. And Hanbala had become hypocrite. Hanbala had become hypocrite. And Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala told him, what are you saying? He said, by Allah, when I'm with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, my iman is very high. But when I leave Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, my iman drops. He said, I'm the same way. He said, I'm in the same case. This is Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى. The man who was with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in the cave, the man with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم wherever he goes, in every battle he was with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the man who is buried next to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the man who will enter paradise with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the man whose heart is next to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, house in Jannah, at the end of his life, he said, I wish I was a plant that people can eat me from the fear of the vengeance of Allah. This is Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه. And Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه. The shaitan, all shayateen used to flee away from Umar. When he used to come this way, shaitan used to take it another way. When they used to hear any sin, they used to flee away. Everyone used to be afraid from Umar because of his power of deen, for his anger for the sake of his deen. Umar is said, brothers, at the end, he's running, crying, and asking Huzaifa, Huzaifa رضي الله تعالى عنه, he's the writer of the book here, the book of Muhammad. He's asking him, is my name in that book? Tell me, he was Amir al-Mu'mineen. Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه, the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offered Islam up. Islam was in secret, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made him as a reason to open all Islam. Open da'wah in Makkah. He's the first man to pray in Ka'bah, in front of Ka'bah. And no one used to tell him anything. A man with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saw his kettle in paradise. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم wanted to enter the kettle. The hand was stopped and said, no, it's not yours, it's the kettle of Umar رضي الله تعالى. Umar رضي الله تعالى, the one who Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if there was a prophet after me, there would be Umar. Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه, when the angels in the grave will ask, who is your Lord? He's the one who will ask his back. Who is your Lord? You ask him, who is your Lord? Ask yourself, who is your Lord? My brothers and elders, at the end of his life, he's running towards Hudayfa, asking him, is he from the Munafiqeen or not? My brothers, now we do the end of Islam. I don't know about, mashallah, your country. In our country now, everyone do a little bit worship. They think they are
from the Jannah al-A'la, Jannah al-Fawz
al-A'la. They have the passport and then the paradise. Tickets in the paradise. This is the ahwal of this ummah. If we can pay our life, the life of Sahaba, we can't compare my life. Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, they sacrificed so much for the sake of this deen. But still they had the fear, still they cried in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Still they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make dua for them. Still they, day and night, they praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, forgive all our sins, and oh Allah, accept from us, and oh Allah, make us from the paradise of Rasulullah. So how many times every day we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us, accept our a'mal at least. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cry how many times in here? In here we cry in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, make us enter into paradise with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much love do we have to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah? How much love do we have to see that Allah, our claim to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah? So much, brothers, this need a lot of efforts. Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they took the way of Rasulullah to gain the highest of qualities, the highest iman, the 100% iman inside their life. And they were the best people, and they are still the best people from their time to this time to the day of judgment, they will be the best people. Because they chose the way of Rasulullah. My brothers, it's not hard. Now we just have to be like Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala. Take the way of Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our only prophet, da'wa ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is his way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِ أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to your ummah, say to everyone, say to Sahaba, say to everyone, tell them to tell the one after them. All this is proven by a hadith on the day of Makkah. He said, have I not told? He said, oh yes, O Rasulullah, you have conveyed the message. He said, now you convey the people of Allah. So convey that this is the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, calling towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the yaqeen that this is the only way, this is the only successful way, the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Myself and my followers. My brother, Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, gave whatever they had to be successful ones. You know what? In the time of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, the people of Medina, they were about to die from hunger. No, nothing was in Medina. It was the year of. Now, once in the time of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, there was nothing in Medina. People were about to die from hunger. Then, people of Medina came to Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and asked, oh Abu Bakr, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us. He said, inshallah, by tomorrow it will be settled. And at night, the 700 camels came with him. On the 700 camels came on the door of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. 700 camels, on the camels everything is provided. You know, only for Uthman radiallahu anhu, he was a big trade man. And then, Uthman, all the tujar, all the traders of Medina came to Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. And they said, oh Uthman, tell us this, we'll give you double the price. He said, no. He said, we'll give you four times the price. He said, no, I'll give you six times. He said, no. He said, I have already sold it to the one who gave me 10 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take all these camels and give them to the people of Medina. Whoever is in need, give him. It is my sadaqa. All these camels is for the people of Medina. Then Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu is one. You always see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inside his dreams. On that night, he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inside his dream. And he saw him in Jannah running, gushing. He said, oh Rasulullah, I've missed you so much. I need to see you. Why are you running away? Why are you running so fast? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Abbas, he said, oh Abbas, today the sadaqa of Uthman was accepted and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called us for his wedding. This is the qualities of Sahaba wa rahmatullah. This is what we need inside our life. True intention to give whatever we have for the sake of deen, whatever we have for the sake of the sunnah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. My brothers, the effort is needed. The effort of Anbiya is needed. It's like to save myself, my family, and the whole ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Oh, you believe, save yourself and your family from hellfire. How we can save ourselves? And how we can save our family with other way than the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. It's impossible. And others, the concern of Sahaba was in the Jannah. To just see Jannah, to be with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. To enter the paradise. That no eyes have seen, no ear have heard of. No one can even see what is in Jannah. When Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم went to Isra'i Mi'raj, he came back to the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنه. He said, oh my companions, you should prepare yourself for a great paradise where Allah has seen colors inside paradise that I have. There's no names, we don't know the names of these colors in Islam. And I have seen things in hellfire where Allah, if you see it, and if you know what I know, you will cry more and love it. This is the word of Rasulullah. My step brothers and elders, how much fikr do we have for the effort of Rasulullah to be revived? A person who on the sunnah of Rasulullah trying to revive the sunnah of Rasulullah and he died with this intention, my step brothers, indeed he will be in glory in paradise. Now a person in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives an example, he is not even responsible for to do da'wah. His name was Habib al-Najjar. We all know the story in Surah Yasin. He gave a few words and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him into paradise. How about the people who are irresponsible from the last ummah and the first ummah to enter to paradise? If they take in this responsibility which was given to them, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be rewarding them? What is the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If he can give the other people paradise and whatever in paradise, why can't he give the ummah of his beloved Prophet the high of paradise if they stick to the effort of his Allah? My brothers and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inside the Quran, he gave us the example how to give da'wah. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the stories, from the hadith, you know how to give da'wah. First thing you give da'wah is the fikr and the hikmah, wisdom. No one Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting around his Sahaba in the desert. And one A'rabi, one Bedouin came. And he hunted a lizard and he put it inside his sleeves to go back to his family and eat. So he saw the group of Rasulullah sitting down. And he said, who is these people? So one man, he said, this is the man who claims the Prophet. So he got really angry and he came. He separated the halaqa. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was there. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was there. He said, oh Muhammad, by Lad and Uzza, you are the most liar person on the face of this earth. And by Lad and Uzza, I hate you the most on the face of this earth. And by Lad and Uzza, if the Arabs won't call me I'm a fast man, I will just cut off the neck right now. So Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he stood up from the anger of the words of his bad words he was referring to Rasulullah ta'ala. He took out his sword and he wanted to cut his neck. He was waiting for the permission of Rasulullah. And Rasulullah, he said, calm down, Umar. أَمَا عَلِمْتَ أَنَّ الْحَلِيمِ كَادَ أَن يَكُونَ نَبِيًّا. Don't you know a kind person? He can be a prophet, Umar. He said, calm down. So Rasulullah, with his wisdom, he gave da'wah to the Arabi. And the Arabi said, are you giving me da'wah as well? Are you talking to me as well? He said, by Lat and Uzza, I will not believe in you until this dead lizard believes in me. So he threw the lizard in front of Rasulullah. And he repeated this word. So Rasulullah, he said, Ya Qab, faqala al-Qab wa qala labbayka wa sa'alayka ya Rasul Rabbil Alameen, bi lisanin arabiyyin mubeen, yashhaduhu jami'u al-Hamilin. Rasulullah said, oh lizard! So the lizard stood up from dead. He said, oh yes, Rasulullah. لذي وجه ما تعبد يا ضب؟ قال أعبد الله في السماء عرشه، وفي الأرض سلطانه، وفي البحر سبيله، وفي الجنة رحمته، وفي النار عذابه. سلعي واجب الله سبحانه وتعالى. The one who stands on top of the sky and his kingdom in the face of this earth and his mercy in Jannah and his punishment in hellfire. He said, who I am, O Rabb? وَمَنْ أَنَا يَا رَبِّ؟ قَالَ أَنْتَ رَسُولُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَخَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ صَدَّقَكَ وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ كَذَّبَكَ. He said, you are the prophet of Allah and the last prophet who ever believed in you, he is successful one. And whoever disobeyed you, he is from the losers. So the A'rabi said, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. And the Rabb, the leader came back to this. This is the quality, this is the hikmah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He couldn't easily say to Umar radiallahu anhu, cut his neck on Umar. But he did not want this. He knew there was a benefit from him. So they taught him some of part of Islam and he went back to his family. While he's going back to Bani Sulaym, he saw 1,000 army men coming with 1,000 swords, with 1,000 camels, coming for a war, a big war. So he told them, where are you going? I might help you. You might need me. So we're going to kill that person who came with the Prophet. So he told them, and he said, hold on, before you go, I need to tell you the story what happened between me and him. And then all of them on that day accepted Islam. From the wisdom of Rasulullah. My respected brothers, this is the da'wah of Muhammad ﷺ. The love of Muhammad ﷺ to the Ummah to enter Islam, to follow his Sunnah, to enter paradise. So how much effort we need, how much effort we require to reach the level of Sahaba and to reach the level to make all these people around us, our family, all the Ummah as stars in the sky. They are likened as a light for us. InshaAllah, my respected brothers. So now we should be ready for any type of requirement come for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us an example how we should be ready to do the da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave us the da'wah, the hudhud make, the bird of Sulaiman radiallahu ta'ala anhu make. He flew in the air for 3,000 kilometers just to give da'wah to human being, and he's not even a human, he's not even responsible. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the fikr inside his head to go and fly. And then, in the other hand, he gives the example of the small ant, giving da'wah to its own kind. No people. Giving da'wah to its own kind. So both da'wah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes. Now we see the difference, my dear brothers. Hudhud in Arabic is a masculine name. And namla is feminine name. Second quality the hudhud has, its color was masculine, like male. And third, a bird, in Arabic means not feminine, means santa, doesn't mean man. So he had the qualities of man, hudhud. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to show us that the effort of man is to fly from country to another country. It's not only by your country. It's not only for your country. Give da'wah to different kind of people. Give da'wah to the white, and give da'wah to the black, give da'wah to the Arabs, give da'wah to non-Arabs, give da'wah to whoever you see. Different kind of people you go around the whole world and you give da'wah. But still, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes the da'wah for the same kind of people. And this da'wah is for our lady. Namla means feminine. And we see the colors of hudur is men colors. Red and whatever, mixed. But namla is black. The ant is black. And its word is mean feminine, woman, in Arabic. And that time, that namla, she was feminine as well. She's the queen of all the ants. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us examples how our ladies should be working together. We give responsibilities for us to go around the whole world and bring this da'wah to our family, and our ladies should do the same effort around their own selves. But this is my respect, brother, this is our responsibility. So who's ready?